Namaste and welcome home. They say where flowers bloom, hope blooms. Today, I would like to take you on a tour of the five most exotic flowers in our garden. I'm really excited. Come on in. In 2019, there was a nationwide poll to choose the new national flower of China. Among 10 nominations, the peonies won the majority of the vote. And this is the reason why it did. And today it is the national flower of China. It's also called as the king of flowers. The peony thrives in warm, dry places with plenty of sunshine. And hence it's a rare find in this part of the world. We are fortunate that these peonies greet all our guests right at our entrance. Next up is bleeding hearts. If you want to have a color splash in your garden, I would recommend you planting them. As the name implies, this plant is known for its pink and white heart-shaped blossoms. It's easy to grow, which makes it popular with novice gardeners just like us, but it's uniquely beautiful. Bleeding hearts are easy to grow in shade and come up in early spring. These pictures that you see are the pictures of early spring. So now, if you're anxious after looking at these two beautiful flowers to find out which is the third one, I'm equally excited to show you the Allium, and also called as the Purple Sensations. Allium is the Latin word for garlic. Garlic, onions, and shallots are all family of Allium. The Purple Sensations are normally planted in November, just before winter sets in, and it blooms in spring. If it's planted in a good place, they will grow for many, many years, and these are perennial plants. If you have a close look at the flower, it seems like a sparkler in a fireworks party. So after looking at these three beautiful flowers, you must be wondering what's up next. What can be more beautiful? Up next is the flaming azalea, as we call it. It's a Mediterranean plant. Legend has it that this was the bush Moses saw when the Bible talks about the flaming bush. I don't know if the legend is true or not, but I can surely say that it's a bright burning flame in our garden. Next up is a color splash. Come on, follow me. Are you ready to see the color splash of the rhododendrons in a cute little corner? Let's go.
Here you can see five varieties of rhododendron in different colors. Rhododendrons are also known as rose tree because it often produces flowers in truces, just like some types of roses. Rhodon is the Greek word for rose, and dendron for tree. Color of the flowers can be white, pastel, orange, golden, red, pink, or purple. Most types of rhododendrons produce fragrant flowers. Rhododendrons love shady spots in the garden, and their buds will be tight little bulbs throughout the year, but it will bloom in spring with a burst of colors. There are around 1,000 varieties, and one of it is the national flower of Nepal.
Next up is a bonus flower. It's a unique conical shaped flower, and it's called as a lupin.
The lupin flower stands for imagination, admiration, and overall happiness. Lupins attract bees, butterflies, and hummingbirds. They have a large white dot on each small flower, directing these insects to the nectar source. The lupin is named after lupus, the Latin word for wolf. Harry Potter fans, do you see any connections?
So this is our first season that we are spending in this house. We moved here in November when the weather was cold, dry, dark, and you know, filled with snow. We are still in the learning phase. We are new to gardening, but every time we come into the garden, we are always surprised by these new beautiful flowers that come up, and we really wanted to share this with you. I hope you liked our video. If you know, please mention in the comment box which was your favorite flower. Like and share and subscribe. We would love to hear from you. Thank you. Have a nice day.